All right, we're back. We're back in Germany. We are back to solve the crime, the many crimes of the Schottenjäger or whatever his name is. Hey everyone, welcome to Conversations with Curtis. I'm Paul Stetler, and thank you for joining our continuing saga of playing Gabriel Knight 2, The Beast Within. When last we... Well, I'll wait to talk about the game until Daniel comes out here. So he'll come out in just a second. And it's good to be here. I was here just 2 days ago, streaming inside on Wednesday on Twitch. And that was a lot of fun. Did my second part of that. So, man, I'm going to stream 3 times this week. It's crazy. I'm a streamer. Who would have thunk it? I'm a streamer. Evening, Zuki. Good to see you, Joseph. Corporal Hicks, good to see you. A lot of names I recognize now. YT Wanderer, welcome. Daniel, you need to, when you get here, I need to remind me to read YT Wanderer's message from last week. All right, I think we're just going to dive right into it. Real quick, I do want to let you know that the announcement that I have, I just want to let all of my Patreon members who might be watching this to know that at the end of this stream, I'm going to have a very cool surprise for you. So keep an eye out for that. So that does give me a quick little... Clement. Hey, man. Thank you. Clement writes, here to start the super chat goal. Yippee. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Disco dance. Disco dance. Disco dance.
That's awesome. Oh, no. There we go. See, this is what drives me crazy. Thank you so much. And unfortunately, I don't see the super chat goal tallying. God, this stream elements is driving me mad. I don't know what I did. I reset it. So I might have to try it again. So I don't know if we'll see a running tally, which is a bummer. But thank you for getting us started. So if you're a Patreon member, I have a really cool surprise for you that will happen at the very end of the stream. So stick around for that. And I think that's it. I'm going to bring Daniel out. I do want to show my Patreon donors just to say thank you, as always. You guys are what makes this possible. And we could not do this without you. I can't say that enough. So if you can join, we'd love to have you. And for those of you who are with us, thank you for being here. All right. So without further ado, I'm going to bring my cohort in all things Gabriel Knight aboard. Everybody, welcome Daniel Albu. Hey, Daniel.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag. Yeah, yeah. Zuki, a dollar. Zuki, hit that like button, everyone. Yes, that would be great.
You should do exactly that.
Do exactly that. So thanks for joining us today. Daniel, how are you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine. What does your t-shirt say? They don't know that we know.
They don't know that we know. That they know we know.
Oh, that's good. From Friends.
It's from Friends.
Nice, nice.
I bought it at the NPC store in 30 Rockefeller.
Wow, when were you there?
In 2013.
All right. It's been a little bit.
Yep.
What was your highlight?
It's been
in
a
New
hot
York?
Minute. My highlight from New York. Well, I stayed at a New Yorker, so I was right next to Times Square. So nice. I was mainly there most of the time.
Very cool. Very cool. All right. So we've got a bunch of stuff to do here. You sent me something to share with everyone before we start.
Yeah, but first we need to read YT Wanderer's message.
Yeah.
He said, all good things come to an end, but great things lie ahead of us. Thank you so much, Victoria and Paul.
Yeah, thank you, YT, for that. I'm sorry I missed it. That was such a fun stream on Monday to finish playing Phantasmagoria with Tori. And I think we had the most people joining us live than we've had playing a game so far. And the comments were just going by like crazy. So I'm sorry I missed that, but you've been, again, just appreciate your generosity. And boy, if you guys got a chance to watch that, thank you for being a part of that. It was so much fun. She's such a delight. And it was a great way to end that game. And if you haven't seen it, then I highly recommend going to our YouTube channel and watching the whole series, and definitely watch the last episode. Did you have fun watching it, Daniel?
Yeah. And even David Holm joined the chat.
He did. We caught him late, and I didn't, again, the chats were going so fast that I didn't even see if he was interacting with us. Was he?
Because he was too busy chasing you in the game.
I know. Did he talk much in the chat?
No. Not that much.
Just popped in. All right, cool. Good to know. Why don't you talk us through we want to watch this stuff first, or do you want to talk us through what we recap?
Well, I checked which TV series, which hit TV show featured several Gabriel Knight 2 actors. So this is what I plan to show today.
All right.
So roll the clip.
Roll the clip. Here we go.
By the way, inside the clip, there's a point when you see the face of the actor in that TV show. And it says, who is this? That's where you can pause and give me your answer before you continue playing.
All right. Here we go.
Let's go. He's a ton of hurry. Hope I didn't hurt.
Miserable without you. I think you should give her another chance. After all, you were married 40 years.
Who is that? All right.
Yeah, who is that?
Oh, let's see. Dang it. You're right. I did this. Hold on a second. Here, let's get back to it. Okay. So I don't know who that is. That's, it's not an actor I recognize, I don't think.
Well, he was in Gabriel Knight 2, and we interacted with him.
He's the zookeeper.
No.
Oh, he's.
We gave him a paw print, and some fur.
Yeah, that's the guy in the lab, right?
Yep.
What's his name?
Well, it's Christopher Shea, and he plays the. The lab guy in Gabriel Knight 2.
Oh, that's
and
awesome.
And in Frasier, he doesn't have any lines. So that's why I had to zoom in.
He's just an extra. That's it in this one?
Yep.
That's awesome. All right, let's check this out.
It's a lighter which indicates a thick undercoat.
We're talking here about something that's old and smelly and dirty.
Hey.
No way!
Not you. I'm talking about Muckabees. Great shoes. Just to sell them.
Yeah.
What happened to the store?
Moved.
Do you know where?
Yeah. It'll cost you.
How much?
Should I stop now? Daniel, should I stop, or do you want me to keep going?
Yeah, when it says who is that,
stop. I know who it is.
Yeah, who is that?
Oh, you can't see. All right. Well, I didn't know you were...
Never mind. Right. I know the.
Yeah, that's the bartender.
What's his full name?
He's the Schottenjägermeister.
He's Velna Huber.
Yeah, he's got a great voice. That's awesome. So cool to see two of them. Is it the same show? Is it the same episode or different shows?
There are two actors from Gabriel Knight who were featured in the same episode.
That's crazy.
But now it's time for a bonus round.
All right, here we go.
How much? Oh,
not money. I wanted kids.
Bonus round. Here we go.
Excuse me, lady. But it seems like your friends can't seem to come up with the 200 they owe me, so I'm going to have to, pardon my French, beat the crap out of them.
Oh my goodness. He's. No way. Is he? No, that was too long ago. I don't know. He's not the. I can't think of who he is. Is he the guy?
He's not from Gabriel Knight 2.
Oh, okay.
From a different FMV game.
Oh, that's Zoltan, right? Zoltan. Yeah. Oh, that's cool.
Zoltan Karnovash.
That's Karno. We got to find him. I hear he works all the time as an actor. I mean, I think he's.
Yeah, he was even in the Fast and Furious saga.
Yeah, he's an abundant. He is a very, very, very active and successful actor in Hollywood. We have to reach out to him. That would be hilarious. All right, that's so cool. This is hilarious. Yeah, there he is.
What can I get you?
And now,
I'll have a decaf latte, and please be sure to use skim milk. I'll have the same.
Got it. Two gutless wonders.
Fine, just tell me where they went.
Oh, someplace called the Topaz Room.
The Topaz Room? I thought the cops shut that place down after the last shooting.
I'll drive.
Oh, well, good.
I'd be happy to help.
Oh, 2 pounds of the Kenya blend. You remembered.
Hard to forget.
Excuse me, you haven't taken my order yet.
Most people find that blend too intense.
Not me. I like something that holds its body on my tongue.
Excuse me, we seem to have spilled something here. If you could just...
I don't suppose you'd be interested in something robust, if it didn't come on too strong.
Oh, if it was a little bit sweet, I might take a liking to it.
Would you like to step over to the counter and try my special blend?
I'd love to.
That's awesome. That is great.
So it seems that Bean isn't acting when he's playing Gabriel Knight. That's actually his character.
That is his character. That's and that must have been his hair too, would be my guess. I bet you he had that long hair with the ponytail. I wonder if they added a ponytail for the part. Is this before or after Gabriel Knight?
Well, he was in Frasier in 93-94, so a year before Gabriel Knight.
Oh, a year before. Wow, that's fascinating. That's great.
Yeah. And the first episode he played was called Space Quest.
Okay. YT Wander just said Dean Erickson should have played a pirate at least once. I completely agree.
Yeah.
All right. Should we do this thing?
Yep.
Let's do it. All right.
We have a pretty long previously.
Okay. Talk us through it.
Okay. So we went to the location where Ludwig the Second's body was found, you know, the memorial cross.
Right.
And we talked to the lead singer of an 80s cover band, who just happens to be a German historian, Joseph Dellmeier. And then we placed the lily in Lake Sternberg in the hope of getting Ludwig's help. But for some reason, the stupid lily worked and Ludwig's spirit helped us. But instead of providing us with a complete walkthrough of the game, we got a fax, a long one. And what else?
Did we read the fax?
We read it. We flirted some more with Georg, the music student from Wagner's Museum. Was very happy to see our fax, which contained an English translation of Ludwig's diary.
Right.
And in the translation, we learned that Ludwig went mad after being bitten in a hunting trip, no less, and that he plans to lift the werewolf curse of his former love interest, the Black Wolf, by the incredible power of Wagner's music as bait.
Oh, wow. This is good to know. I didn't think I put all this together. So I feel like I'm hearing this for the first time.
So Georg, being flirtatious and all, shows us Wagner's wife's diary, where we learn of the existence of the lost opera. And then we got to chapter 5. And boy, were you in for a surprise.
Sure was.
Gabriel Knight and Von Glauer took off their shoulder pads and turned that place into a bachelor pad. And
speaking
then we got
of shoulder pads, I felt like Dean was wearing fairly large shoulder pads on, and he was just wearing a shirt, or maybe he doesn't wear shoulder pads, maybe he just is that broad.
He has shoulder pads in his robe, a special robe with shoulder pads. Then we got free exchange of sex and drinks, and Von Glauer ran his hand through Gabriel's hair and touched his plastic talisman.
Yep.
Happy Pride, everyone.
Yeah, you know, so hearing about I asked the question, is that on purpose or is that just suggestive? And it's according to everybody, and especially knowing Jane Jensen's writings before and after this, this is very much a theme that she explores. And it's great. That was really cool. I was totally surprised by that, especially after how sort of misogynistic the earlier part was, you know, trading.
Yeah, well, it was a year before Phantasmagoria, so they couldn't get that progressive.
Yeah, right.
They were halfway there.
Yeah, right. But anyway.
You got Van Glauer and Gabriel, but you still got the misogynistic plot lines.
And him putting his hand through Gabriel's hair. But the other thing that I thought about is that doesn't Van Glauer have darker hair, like sort of blackish hair, as opposed to Gabriel, who has lighter brown hair?
So you think it's a light and dark motif?
A little bit. Well, like we have the black fur and the brown fur, and just the idea that Von Glauer is touching his hair and sort of matching or looking at, you know, that he's attracted to the fur in his tribe or his you know, pack. That's my thinking. I think Von Glauer is a werewolf. I'm pretty sure. I mean, how can he not be? So that's what I got. Should we do this thing?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. All right. Hopefully everything's on. I see desktop audio. All right. We've been yapping for 20 minutes. Let's play some. Where am I? What's the last thing that happened? We just left Von Glauer's house, right? So this is a walk of shame.
The problem with my previously is that we're talking about the previous episode, but in this game, you always skip a chapter in order to play with the same character. So now you need to remember what was the last thing we did back in chapter 3.
Last thing we did back in chapter 3 was, well, we watched, oh, before the movie scene, right? Somebody, I think, followed or subscribed, and the widget went so fast I didn't see it. So thank you for anybody who did that. I don't remember. You can just talk. You can remind me of that. Just get
okay. On. We placed the tape recorder inside the...
Oh, boy.
A tape recorder was placed in...
The oh boy came at the exact time.
Corporal Perfect Hicks, timing. Thank you very much. Good to see you guys and everybody on the chat. The pace picks up in this chapter. All right, good. Well, my pace is about as slow as can be because I can't remember anything. I put a tape recorder in like in a newspaper or something. Now, what did I, where was I? Here, just tell me where I was again.
You were in the hunting club and you took the tape recorder and you placed it in the magazine.
Right, the magazine.
And the chapter ended.
Oh, so we got to go back and find out. Okay, all right. So we're back with Gabriel. All right. Yeah, I forgot because I just spent all this time.
Because it's been Grace. 5 weeks or
it has. It's been forever, yeah. So I guess I'm going to go to the hunting club. Let's do that. All right, let's see. Skip ahead. And we showed, oh, we haven't done this yet, but we were going to show pictures of, we'll probably do that on our last stream when we show pictures of the actual place and maybe show some of the video from
maybe we'll do that next week.
Adventure Game Geek. Okay, that'd be fun. All right, let's go here. Wait, there's two places. That noise. Wait, isn't there? Wait, there's that. Where's the hunting club? It's not letting me go to the hunting club.
Because that's the post office. You need to go to the hunting club.
But isn't the hunting club over here?
No, it's up north. It's up north.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Thank you, Monk Dabs, the Phantasm 1 finale was awesome. Great work. Thank you. That was a special, special thing. Not that you're not special, Daniel.
Yeah. Thanks, guys.
Wait, I thought the hunting club was... I'm confused where the hunting club was. I was convinced that it was like right next
to... Go up the street and then go up the street again.
This way, you mean?
No.
Okay.
That street.
Yeah. This way, right?
Yep.
Yeah, that's what I just did.
But now,
isn't the Honey Club right there?
No. You need to go up the street.
I'll have to go up the street. Exit the street. There we go. Now we go.
Exit the street.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, now we can go.
Exit can be from going up the street to having a zoom in on the post office.
All right, let's talk to our buddy here.
The men will be meeting here later today for the trip. I'm sure they won't wait for you, so you might want to be on time.
I'll be here. Sweet of you to worry, though.
No sound? There should be sound. Is anybody else having trouble? There's tons of sound from OBS. Yeah, okay. Good. Don't scare me like that, Joseph.
I'm not in the mood to communicate with the dead today.
Again, I haven't been here in a while. There's a part of me that feels like I should check out this area, even though I know that the... Well, I'm just going to wander. Let me wander around a little bit. No, that took me outside. I don't want to go outside.
Did you forget how to play the game?
Oh, yeah. I've totally forgotten. I just don't remember. I'm playing a bunch of games that have a lot of space, and my brain can't remember all of them. Zuki, thank you.
She's saying that we can hear game voices, but not music.
Oh.
So you might want to turn up the music.
Well, let's check it out. I wonder why that is. Is there always music during the... You see, like, there should be music right now?
Yeah, let's go out to the street and hear if we have any background sounds.
There's background sounds.
We have... Okay. But, okay, so go back to the hunting part.
Okay. So let's do
this. Okay. If you want, you can sing Rage, because it feels like people want some music in this scene.
We can hear game voices with no music, hopefully. So I hear music now. Do you guys hear music?
Yeah.
All right. Go further inside the club. All right, let's go. There's nothing around here.
I don't think I should get too comfortable.
Do you remember why we came here?
We're going to get the recording.
Yeah. Where did we place it?
We put it in a... I don't remember. I have no clue.
I thought Germans only drank beer.
Here somewhere? Wait. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah, between the armchairs. Yeah.
He's so funny the way he... Oh, my God. That was so smooth. I mean, no one would know he was trying to find something. So now I think...
Especially since no one's there.
So since no one's here, I imagine I can do the tape recorders now. In real life, I would probably go back to my house or something to listen to them. This doesn't seem like the place to do it. But I feel like my spidey sense is telling me I should do that now. I still want to see what those rooms are, but let's see. So there's that, and then I need to do what? I forgot how to. Ah. All right.
Great job.
Yeah. These are the tapes. Are these the tapes? No, those are the tapes. What's going on? If I wanted to, where do I find that tape recorder area?
Click the exit and you have the tape recorder area in the same location. Yep, that's
this
the
one?
Button. No, the button with the tape.
The button with the tape. The button with the tape. I did that already. Oh, there we go. I clicked that.
Yep.
Okay, so here we go. Do I get to see Oh, I recorded everybody.
Yeah, that's the point of the tape recorder.
Dang, that's a lot of people. There's only like two people standing next to each other, though. All right, so I guess we're going to start listening to folks.
No, why would you? These are conversations that you already had with these people. Now we just, you know, if you want to review things that you've talked about, you don't need to listen to those tapes. We have a tape of a conversation of Von Zell and whoever.
But how don't I want to listen to it?
First of all, check if you have it in the inventory, and then you might want to place it in the tape recorder.
Well, I thought, okay.
Or.
Hold on. Let's just get back to.
Or.
Here was the tape. And so what I was going to do, not knowing how to play games, was I was going to either click on him, see if something happened, or I was going to take the tape and try to put it, because this is the tape I just picked up from the magazine, right? So I was going
to... It says Von Zell.
Yeah, so I was going to take this tape. It seems to me that the time is right to try to listen to this tape. So that was what I was trying to do by getting to the tape recorder area, is to take this tape and listen to it. But I don't... So I don't think if I click it on here, nothing's happening. And if I click on the tape, it's not doing anything. So how do I listen to this tape? That I don't know.
You don't need to listen to this tape because it's in German and you don't know German.
Okay, good call. So I have to translate.
But maybe someone in Germany knows German.
Okay. So I just have
Maybe it. We can find someone.
Okay.
Anyone to help us translate this tape.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
Someone nice who can plan. Be discreet.
It just leads to a back alley.
Can I go out of here?
I don't think I'm going to get down there.
So I got to go talk to a German person.
Yeah.
How about this guy? I don't think he's going
to... I'm not in the mood to communicate with the dead today.
All right. Okay, so who do I go talk to? I've got a lot of German friends. I'll go talk to my lawyer buddy. I trust him.
Okay.
Hiya.
Thank you so much. I'm not going to say your name wrong. Kajetel Hansen. Thank you very much. That was very sweet. Appreciate it. And my apologies for butchering your name. All right, let's go talk to our... Keep going this way. No, I guess I have to go on. There we go. No, James just wrote, I guess to a non-gamer, combining items in the inventory is not an intuitive action. I think that's very true. That's not intuitive. And thanks, Suki. You're keeping our super chat goal up to date. Since my stupid widget doesn't work, I think I'm going to take those widgets off right now because I failed. And we'll just keep a running tally because you guys all... have good math.
Because you guys are awesome.
And they're smart too. All right, here we go.
Ah, good morning, Gabriel.
She Another never changes. Came from Ritter's or does she?
A request for me and.
Ladies in Red is a recurring motif in this game.
Yeah. He gave me a letter. That's probably from.
From what's her face?
From what's her face? All right, come on. Something's got to pop up here. I usually get questions. You kind of made it clear. I'm going to do this first just because I want to see. Missing persons.
Have any luck with that missing person search?
Oh, of course. I forgot. Frau Hogel dropped off something this morning. Yes, there are two forest areas where missing persons incidents are concerned. The Nationalpark Bayerischer Wald and the Naturpark Schwäbisch-Frankischer Wald. Frau Hogel checked both these areas back 10 years. Between 1960 and 1969, there were only 1 to 2 cases a year in the Bavarian National Forest area. Between 1970 and 1990, there were 10 to 12 cases each year. Oh. Hmm. In 1991, it went up to 17, then went back down to 12 in 92 and 93. The Schwäbisch-Frankischer Waldfickers are similar.
Curious.
Does something ring a bell?
If it does, I should be able to hear it loud and clear. I'm leaving this afternoon for the Bavarian National Forest.
Okay. All right. Now I'm going to give him this tape. What did we just learn, Daniel?
Learned about missing persons.
Yeah, these are the most recent missing persons, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, no. Oh, there we go. Not going to let me.
Can I bother you for another favor? I need something translated, and I need somebody I can trust to do it.
And you're asking me? You obviously don't know German lawyers.
Harry, you're such a kidder.
What's up, Yala Balagan? Good to see you.
Okay. Here it is.
Wir müssen miteinander reden.
We should talk?
Nein.
No? No.
Es ist meine Karriere, verdammt noch einmal.
It's not safe.
Vielleicht sogar mehr, wenn die...
His career is in danger, even if the police...
Ich habe Ihnen doch gesagt, nicht darüber zu sprechen.
I told you not to speak of it.
Aber ich denke mir, dass die Polizei bereits weiß, dass unsere Wölfe nichts damit zu tun haben. Die können einen Test machen, an den Körpern.
The police must know that our wolves are not responsible. They are tests they can perform on the bodies.
Gut. Ihre geflüchteten Wölfe sind keine Killer. Was soll's? Halten Sie nur Ihren Mund. Sie sind damit besser dran.
So, your escape wolves are not the killers. What's the problem?
Aber Herr Knight, er kam gestern Morgen zu meinem Büro. Er hat viele Fragen gestellt.
Thanks, Lai.
He
Thank
says
you,
you've
Yala
been
Malaga.
Asking a lot of questions.
Worüber?
About what?
Love you.
Über die Wölfe.
About the wolves. Who are these men?
Just friend. I think there's more.
Was ist los von Eigner?
Wow,
ich muss mit jemand anderem reden.
He doesn't want to talk, says he has someone else to speak to.
Ich habe mir gedacht, wissen Sie etwas über Großbergs Tod?
Do you know anything about Großbergs death?
Wieso sollte ich?
Why the hell should I?
Nun, ganz einfach. Ich gab Ihnen seinen Namen.
I gave you his name.
Und?
And?
Und er fragt mich, ob ich Großberg kenne.
And?
He says you asked him if he knew Großberg.
Was?
I think I know what happens next.
I don't.
You know, it would be a great tragedy if the Ritterlein were to die out. A great, great tragedy. I'm not just talking about for the sake of our firm, but...
I know what I'm doing, Harry.
Oh. I don't know what's going on. I get kind of, it's, I think that streaming in front of people, I'm trying to be cognizant of what people are saying, seeing folks chatting, and then listening to what is a lot of information. Mm-hmm. And I'm not listening to the information probably the way I would if I was just playing this game by myself. But my guess, here's what I think I gathered was, they talked about him, and I think the lawyer is sort of saying that he's kind of not in on it, but he's hoping that Gabriel will continue the Ritter line, which seems to me to be connected to this werewolfery. Am I on the right track? Or does it don't or do you not want to tell me yet?
Well, first of all, from the missing persons, we learn about the missing persons around the hunting lodge. Because that's what Gabriel wanted to find out.
Right.
And what we found out here was the fact that Von Zell and Klingman, which were the two guys who were talking, were responsible for the Zools' escape, while they know that they're not the killers.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
So I got nothing else to share with him.
I don't have anything else to say now.
That's what I just thought.
Well, you got a letter from him. Maybe you should read that bad boy.
Oh, I thought the letter was from Grace. All right.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't want to give it to him, though. I'll read it.
He gave you the letter. You should read it.
Yeah. Okay. Sounds good. I'm going to click on him anyway. Nope.
I'm not sure why I'd want to show him that.
Get the letter back. I don't want to hear from Grace.
That's me, Gabriel Knight.
Excellent. All right, let's go. Let's go somewhere. Let's get out of here.
I'm off. See you, Harry.
Goodbye.
Yep, he's making a phone call.
He's calling 911.
You know what? He does that phone call a lot after, and I think that he's calling the hunting club to say, I talked to them. I think he's a
555 hunt.
I think he's a double agent. Huh. Still nothing.
White sausage.
Okay, why don't we just
Yum.
Check?
Maybe you should try paying her.
Oh, really? Really? I could have paid her all this time. And I never did.
My wallet. It actually has money in it these days.
Well, how do I get? I guess I don't have to.
It actually has money in it these days.
I don't have to look
Wait,
it up.
You wanted to open?
Yeah.
You wanted to open the wallet?
Don't you have
give
to
give her the wallet?
Don't I you have to do that as Curtis, though? Curtis has to open
You have
the
to
wallet.
Do that as Curtis to find the key card.
Well, see, I'm just a creature of habit now.
Can I have some of that Weisswurst?
Hey.
Sechs Mark, bitte.
See? Was this available all this time?
No.
Aw.
Disco dance! Disco dance! Disco dance!
Boromir Smith, thank you so much. Appreciate that. The 90s in an FMV time capsule. Mesmerizing. Indeed. Indeed. Zuki, how are we doing? All right. Well, I'm so thrilled. We got to talk to our vendor here and get ourselves some. What do we have? I have some meat. Can I eat it?
That's me, a white sausage.
It looks like a Coca-Cola because there's a little straw right there. All right, I guess I can't do anything with that now. So where do I want to go? I guess, do I have to go home to read a letter, or when can I?
You can read the letter here. You need privacy?
I just couldn't do it before because I had a picture of someone else. I need to be able to click it on him.
No, you have the magnifying glass to look at stuff.
Oh, God dang it. I thought I had to have him.
You see, you're used to Phantasmagoria 2 logic. First of all, in Phantasmagoria 2, combining items happens only mid-game when you need to combine the hammer and the screwdriver to open the metal box.
Yeah, I know.
In addition to that, you need to use items on people to talk.
That's not what I want to do. Stupid thing. So I want to read the letter, and I need to do that by bringing the letter to there, right? There we go. Now we're talking. All right, Grace, what do we got?
Reading.
Gabriel, I've been busy on this case, and it's starting to pay off. Thought I'd fill you in. There's definitely something going on with Ludwig II. I'm pretty sure he was involved with a werewolf. In fact, he was probably turned into one himself.
Oh, nice.
Anyway, something happened to him on this hunting trip, and afterwards he fits the profile in the lore book to a T. It's really fascinating. There's an American couple here, the Smiths. They're from Pennsylvania, if you can believe it. Mrs. Smith has been telling me all about your fortune, and she's sure you're tied in with Ludwig somehow. She also told me to warn you to beware the Black Wolf. Have you learned anything about that yet?
Yeah.
So don't tell me where you're staying, as if I care. Really, we're supposed to be a team, Gabriel. I'm holding up my end. I've about done all I can down here, and if you want, I can join you there soon. Perhaps I'll see something I recognize from my research. I'm serious, Grace.
Christ, she's losing it. Ludwig II, a werewolf. Yeah, right.
That's hilarious. I thought Grace was much more tempered this time. She seemed a little more relaxed and just communicating effectively. I don't know. I liked this Grace. And then he comes along. And
you liked chapter 4 Grace, but chapter 2 Grace is still...
Yeah, chapter 2 Grace was a little scary.
Emoting too much.
Yeah, a little much. But yeah, I like this Grace. Excellent. Well, this is good. Let's see. Where to go now? I've already listened to this stuff. I had the letter. I guess at this point.
So. We're never going to finish this game.
Well, true. I can't get out of here. How do I get out of here? But I don't know where to go. I'm going to go downstairs and see what's next. See what they want me to look at. Okay,
maybe we have new locations.
I see these two. Is there another one since that? But that's not in there? There's this one.
The first one you're in, so this...
Yeah, well, there we go. Well, I did this on purpose. This is good.
I couldn't find Steve in there another one in your app.
Oh, God, can you guys hear that? There.
The American P.I.
Criminal Commissar Lieber. I couldn't just call you KKL, could I?
Sit down.
KKL.
Sit down.
How about KKK?
Okay, we got some questions to ask. What's the case status?
What's the status on the case?
There's nothing new that I can share with you.
Is there anything new that you can't share with me?
That's it. They did that whole scene just for that moment.
Yeah, amazing, amazing.
Okay, let's try this. You haven't found the zoo wolves yet?
No.
Have you caught anything yet?
No. No.
Why am I not surprised?
Ooh, burn. Take that, police chief. Yeah, he gave him a zinger there. Gooseberg's account.
Keep kind going. Of a funny thing. I talked to Grossberg's assistant. It was a fluke, really. But she mentioned you guys took some of Grossberg's ledgers.
I told you to stay out of our business, Knight.
True, true. Why did you guys take ledgers if Grossberg was just a random victim?
As long as this case is open, I'm going by the book. That means a standard background check on the victim.
Find anything?
I don't think anyone's looked yet. We'll probably assign one of the younger men to do it. As you say, Grossberg was a random victim.
Did I say that?
I was going to say he said that. Did I say that? Yeah, okay. There's more to Grossberg's account.
I don't suppose you'd let me take an eensy-weensy look at Grossberg's ledgers.
Absolutely not.
We're gonna try.
What if I could prove that Grossberg wasn't a random victim?
You're crazy.
Am I?
Look, if you have information, I want to know what it is now.
What information? Look, 5 minutes with the ledges. If Grossberg was a random victim, my looking won't matter. And if not, I may be able to help you out. You got nothing to lose either way.
That's a good point.
I don't believe you know anything. No papers.
Okay, now we got to figure out how to get to the papers. Dun, 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 dun.
The guys in the chat decided to play a drinking game and to drink whenever Dean Erickson sighs. Oh, so I think that by the end of this scene,
they're going to be drunk.
Yeah.
Well, you guys know something. You guys know something I don't know. But I thought you were going to say you're going to drinking game of every time I make a stupid decision. So he needs to get those papers. They just told us that he's got to get the papers. We've got to figure out all the stuff here to.
At least he's neater than Detective Mosley.
Okay.
At least he.
All right. So there's that.
I'm sure nothing's changed since the last time I looked at the map.
Okay, there's
nothing. Probably nothing of interest back there. Besides, I can't see past a commissar.
Maybe you can convince
him. Hold on. Let me just play around.
Maybe you don't need to convince him.
About those ledges. I've got a feeling I won't be able to just talk my way past this one.
So, I got a hot dog. Oh, he's a hungry guy. I'm going to give him a hot dog.
Yeah, that's the solution.
I don't think that would impress Lieber.
Dang it. Can I eat it? Why do I have a hot dog? That's going to come in handy at some point. I guess I leave here. No, I have to get the papers, right? So.
Yep.
I don't remember half the stuff that I what's going to, I don't even know what this stuff is. So that's the barely started.
Which languages? Commissar Lieber know?
He knows German. Oh, he knows a bunch of languages, right? Gabriel's
name two.
English and German.
Okay. Maybe we have something in German to share with him.
I'm going to look. I don't remember all the stuff. We have the tape. Am I going to give him the tape? I guess I'll give him the tape.
Yeah, why not?
All right. Is that the tape?
I don't think that would impress me.
I didn't have the tape. All right. I didn't have the tape. There are times, and you guys all have to back me up on this, that you click on something and you're like sure that you've clicked on it and it didn't activate it. Or maybe your cursor was just a little bit off. And so you thought that it didn't work and then you moved on and you found out later that you just didn't click it right. That has happened to me a lot. No? There we go. Thank God.
If I can convince you I do know something new about this case, will you let me see Grossberg's ledgers?
I'm listening.
Listening?
Good. Keep it up.
This game is harder than Phantasmagoria, I think.
Ich denke mir, dass die Polizei bereits weiß, dass unsere Wölfe nichts damit zu tun haben. Die können einen Test machen an den Körpern.
Gut. Ihre geflüchteten Wölfe sind keine Killer. Was soll's? Halten Sie nur Ihren Mund.
It's like he's dead.
Sie sind damit besser dran.
Aber Herr Knight, er kam gestern Morgen zu meinem Büro. Er hat viele Fragen gestellt.
Worüber?
Über die Wölfe.
Ich habe mir gedacht.
Wow. They're going to have us listen to all the German.
So sollte ich.
Yeah.
Nun ganz einfach.
This is fascinating.
Ich gab ihnen seinen Namen. Und
you would.
The ledgers first, please.
Stata, bringen Sie Großbergs Papiere herein.
Oh.
Danke, Starter. Das ist alles.
Starter. Very close to Stetler. Okay, we got some papers.
I'm going out for some coffee. You'd better have something important to tell me when I get back, Knight, or you'll learn more about Chairman Law Enforcement than you ever cared to know.
All right. Shut the fake door. And now we can read some stuff. We got some reading to do.
He's usually overacting. Now he was overacting. Overacting.
I can't tell anymore. He's very consistently over. I don't know.
Yeah.
All right. Couple.
Maybe you can take something while he's gone.
Yeah, I'm not going to do anything right now. I'm gonna take a minute, and I'm gonna assess some things. Can't remember. Oh, I also want to. CT by CV just wrote. You were looking through the files for Phantas 1, and it looks like early in the production they screen tested somebody else for as Adrian. I found some really bad quality animations of whoever it was. Oh, that would be awesome. Yes, please send that. Put that on Discord.
Yeah, I replied on the chat.
That would be fun.
I saw them as well.
Oh, sweet. So, yeah, that's all. I just wanted to check the chat, say hi to folks, see how you're all doing. So we got a good group. Elvish Cat, good to see you. I was told by Daniel, actually, maybe he's, tell me if he's right, that on Twitch, people will pretty much read every comment in the chat as much as they can. There's a ton of engagement with the chat, and I don't do that very, very much. So I'm curious if is that true? And how do you ever get through a game? You guys tease me about how slow I am, but how would anybody get through a game if they're constantly talking to the chat? That's my question. All right, so let's take a look here. Okay, I got some stuff. Exotish exports. Dorn. Dun, 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 dun. No. You have to do that fake sneeze when you do that. You have to go, ha-choo, shoo. Oof.
Where's the coffee?
Hey, where's your coffee?
Feather! Kommen Sie her und nehmen Sie die Papiere weg.
This is... Yeah, so... Here's what I wanted to talk about. It takes right. So Spill long.
It. Yep.
I mean,
Herr Dr. Klingman from the zoo.
Yes.
He belongs to a men's club, right? And the guy that was men's asking club. About Grossberg, well, he's in that club too. Ditto the third guy, the one with the personality of a pit bull.
Go on.
The guy that was asking about Grossberg, he was listed in one of Grossberg's address books. They knew each other. In the club, these fellas all patronize is only blocks from where Grossberg was killed. Coincidence?
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
Good work. We'll have the club investigated immediately. You'll have to leave that tape here.
Wait a minute. I'm already in with these guys. You go in there with your SWAT troop and my stool pigeon days are over.
Sorry, but I'm in charge of this case, and now I have a lead. I can't depend on a civilian to do my job. What's the name of this club?
I'm not going to tell you.
Friendly Wanderers.
The douchebags.
The Friendly Wanderers.
It's near the university.
Okay. I appreciate the information. But as of now, I want you to disappear. we'll handle everything.
Sure.
He just gave them the wrong name, right?
Good luck, Lever.
555 Hunting Club.
What? The tape. Here's what I want to say really quick. I don't want to listen to this, so let's go. Where do I gonna go?
You have a new location.
I got a new location right over here.
I want to talk about the editing of this game.
Me too. This is exactly what I want to talk about right now. So let's take a second. I'm going to scoot over and let us just chat. So here is what blows my mind. So like it's, you have to excuse it. It's 1995. They're doing groundbreaking gaming. You know, they're doing things that no one's ever done before. I get all that. And I get that Jane has decided to make a game that has a lot of information, and she's doing something that's, you know, she requires you to listen, and she requires you to, you know, she gives you information to learn and put together like a good mystery. But the editing, there's just so much space in between the beginning of a scene, sitting down, the end of a scene, getting up, putting their coat on, walking out. All this stuff could so easily have been trimmed. Like I wonder what the choice was for making us listen to the German recording again and watch the police chief watch it. Like, what does that do? And these are choices that I think even back in 1990, whatever, when the editing wasn't as insane as it is now. I think that I'm just curious where that came from. What's your thoughts?
Well, since the editing has been a problem for me as well, especially the fact that scenes run like 2 seconds too long.
Always.
At the start of each conversation, I understand that they need to show us that Gabriel or Grace are preparing to start a conversation on a certain topic. So you need to see them leaning into it. But they do a face, and then they don't move for 2 seconds, and the scene ends. It's horrible.
Yeah.
So what do I usually do in these cases? I look up the people who made this particular thing. Like, I looked up the person who designed the inventory icons on Phantasmagoria 2 in order to confront him about the icons. So I wanted to confront the editor of Gabriel Knight 2. So I looked him up.
This is great.
His name is Peter Lonsdale. And before he did this game, he was associate editor on Back to the Future 1, Back to the Future 2, Back to the Future 3, The Rocketeer, JFK. I'm talking about Academy winners for JFK. I think it won the Academy Award for Best Movie.
He was the associate editor on all of those?
Yeah.
Maybe there's a reason he never became a chief editor. I don't know. What did he ever become an editor of his own? That level?
He was the editor on Gabriel Knight.
Yeah. Yeah. So did you ever try to get a hold of him?
No.
Okay. Maybe we need
because
to.
He's a big shot now.
Yeah.
He edited Tron Uprising, which is an animated series. I don't know if you saw it.
No, I heard of it.
He edited an episode of Phineas and Ferb.
Oh, nice. Nice. Oh, good. Well, I'll bet you they're faster.
So, again, you know, Back to the Future 1 and 2, you're not watching these movies and saying, this is edited poorly.
Right.
Like we're saying in this.
Well, Joseph is making an example about Twin Peaks being a good example of slow, drawn out scenes. But But there's a, I don't know, there's a difference when it feels, this doesn't feel like a director's choice. That it does feel like it's an editor not knowing the best times to start and stop. Anyways, let's get back to the game. All right, let's get you guys. So we're in a new place. This is new. Where are we? We're in Grossberg's. Oh no, that's the tape. Okay. We have the ripped out page from Grossberg's account. So that's the thing. And I'm in a new place, right? So do I have that. I only have one place to go. Let's go there. Can't remember if we've been here before.
Hello, are you Mr. Dorn?
No, we haven't.
Yes. What do you want?
My name is Knight. I'm an associate for Grossberg's.
Grossberg? That son of a bitch owes me a lot of money. Now he's dead. Who's going to pay me, huh?
I'll be handling Grossberg's accounts. If you could just tell me what services you perform for him exactly, I can get you a check right away.
I don't talk to nobody about what I do. You pay me what I'm owed. Maybe you and I can do business together. Otherwise, I've had enough of Grossberg and his associates.
Two, three, four. Good 4 seconds.
Magic Herring said, I'm not sure if that's true, but I read somewhere that a lot of old FMV games left in a few seconds extra at the start and at the end of many video sequences because older systems would sometimes need the extra time just to buffer. If they weren't there, the clip would sometimes start in the middle of a conversation. Now, that may be true for the beginning of the clip because it would take time to buffer, but not at the end. There's no need for an extra 2-3 seconds at the end.
I know what to do.
Yeah, I do need to do.
He's gonna say, I got nothing else to tell you.
You again. Do you have the money Grossberg owed me?
No, but I got something else.
Give him the sausage.
No, I don't want the sausage comes into. When does it come in?
I don't think he'll take a trade.
Oh, really?
I don't think he'll take a trade.
All right, you win this one, Gabriel Knight game. And maybe I will give him the sausage.
I don't hungry? Think he'll take a trade.
Can't stand here all day. Come back when you're
you have the fidgeting
cash.
As if it's a drug deal.
Oh, no.
Oh. He sent you away. He sent you to the map.
He sent me to the map, and there's nothing. Oh, hit. I go back to Marienplatz. So, he.
Who can get us money?
Yeah. I knew that. Quick. The policeman. The police chief. He's shadier than anybody else. But I'll go to the lawyer instead. All right, let's see. The secretary still wearing her red dress. She is. No, she's not wearing a dress.
Gabriel.
Leggings and a shirt.
Hey, Harry.
All right, need some money. Want a hot dog? Nope. All right. Give him this thing? Nope. It's not going to work either. Wait. I just got to click on. Maybe I just have to click on. Getting cash.
Could you pull some cash for me from the Ritter account?
Sure. How much do you need?
Dang.
14,000 marks.
I want to be able to say that to people.
Are you sure it's wise to carry so much?
I won't be carrying it long.
You can ask the chat. Hey, chat, can you pull some cash for us from the Ritter account?
Frau Hogel, gehen Sie zur Bank und holen Sie mir 14,000 Mark vom Ritterkonto ab. Yeah, schönen Dank. Perhaps you'd like to make out a will while we wait.
How about if I just leave everything to you?
I wish you would leave everything to me.
He's gonna murder him at the end of this scene.
He's gonna.
From the looks of it.
Aw, she got a bigger part.
Thanks, darling.
She doesn't get to say anything, though. You always want to.
Hey,
lie.
Monk Tapes got us money from the Rear account.
Hey, Monk Tapes. Thank you. How come that didn't show up? Didn't show up on the thing. There we go. It's a little slow today. All right. So many things going through my head. This guy, do I want to play the game? What did you just say before that, Daniel? We're getting some cash. He said we only have it for so long. She brought stuff.
I don't have anything else to say right now.
Unless I want to. Does this do anything? Not really. Or is it?
Oh, piss off conversations with Curtis.
Super chat. Thank you, Godfet. Appreciate
that.
He
also got us money from the Ritter account.
That's right. We got the Ritter account. So this is my wallet now, right? What is that? Yeah, $14,000. I can go now. I don't think I need to do anything now. I think I got what I needed.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's hit the road. I do think he's in on it. I think he's in on it. I think he's a...
Why? Because he seemed so eager to have us killed to get them.
Yep.
Get all of our money.
Oh, and you see, every time he leaves, he's like, okay, I just talked to him. He's on his way over to the Hunt Club. So, yeah, he's... Let's see if I need another hamburger. Gotta check my wallet.
Give her back the sausage. Ask her if there's a money back guarantee on the sausage.
No, I know. He's like, can I at least exchange it? He hasn't actually. No, it's not gonna. Oh,
I've got plenty of meat already. Thanks.
Oh, you got to write that. You got to say that line. I got plenty of meat already. Thanks. All right, let's get out of here. When can I eat the hot dog? To come in handy.
Whenever you're hungry.
No, I tried it.
No, it's a puzzle. You need to find a bun and then combine the items.
You do not. James Jenkins from Von Rolick. Thank you very much, man. Appreciate it. And Jocelyn appreciates it too. She loves you. Envy Scripts.
People actually got us money from the Rare account. Thank you, guys.
Envy Scripts Music TV. Pixelated Hippo Chomps on a 1-up. Thank you. Appreciate that. Please like the video. We got a bunch of people watching, so it'd be great to have some likes and point other people towards it. I guess I'll go back down, see what I need to do. I like the little hint button. Oh, I had a feeling I had to go to like the Hunt Club, so why don't I do that? Maybe not the Hunt Club. What else?
That's but why you have the money.
I love you.
Oh my goodness, people. Clement! Dude, thank you so much. From Wolfgang Ritter, can't do more. Heart surgery ongoing. Oh man. Good luck with that. That's scary, and I hope gonna be a great long-term solution for you. Wait. I have money. What do I do with the money? Do I take it to the... I'm here.
Why did we ask Ubergrau for the money?
I don't remember. We wanted the money because...
Because someone... Why did we get that specific sum of money?
Who was he with? Was it the police guy?
No. Someone asked us for this amount of money.
I've already forgotten.
Like 10 minutes ago.
Who was the last person we talked to? We were with the policeman... And then we went to...
We're never going to finish this game.
Oh, we went to the guy. I know what to do. The dude. All right. Yeah. Okay. Gotcha. I got to go back. But this was saying it was red. I thought that meant I should keep staying here. I knew I had to go here. I just didn't know I had to go there first.
We got even more money from the Rear account.
Hi-ya.
Thanks, Mighty Wanderer. Yep, you got the...
No, you play widgets with super chat and goals.
Yeah.
All we had to do was ask people to give us money from the Ritter account.
That's it, Ritter time. But You saying we're never going to finish this game because I didn't go here first, but the Marienplatz was also blinking and blinking red. So I looked at that thinking, oh, that's a hot spot that I should probably...
It's blinking. It's red because you're there. Otherwise, it would have been yellow.
But it was still blinking,
and
right?
It's blinking because you click the hint button and it blinks on locations that you still have things to do in.
Right. So why couldn't I have stayed in Marienplatz and
you could have stayed there. But usually in adventure games, when you have an obvious solution to a certain puzzle, like getting a specific amount of money, asked for it.
That's where I go astray. I think, okay, I got the money. I'll go talk to that guy later. I'm going to go explore some more. I would be the slowest detective in the history of the world. Clement from Gerda.
Hiya.
Account took a hit after the Silver Heart. Thank you very much. Gerda, I got to reach out to her again. I'm ready. I'll do that today. I'm going to have an interview with her. She's already agreed to it. So looking forward to that. All right, let's go talk to this dude. Yep, there's a sigh. Someone has to take a drink. Another sigh.
You again. Do you have the money Grossberg owed me?
I do indeed. Why? Oh, he's looking in his pocket. He's like trying to help us. Is this my money? There it is. Come on.
I don't have anything like...
What?
I don't have anything like 14,000 Deutschmarks in my wallet.
Maybe it's not in your wallet.
I clicked this. This says 14,000 Deutschmarks. I clicked this.
Mm-hmm.
And I did that. That's what I just did. That's what I just thought that I did.
14,000 marks. In cash.
I don't think Gerda wears her 80s perm anymore, James. Ooh, a little cello action. Zuki.
Please.
Zuki just wrote, as your accountant, FYI, this takes you over $100. Wow, that is awesome.
Thank you, guy.
Thank you.
That's a new record.
Thank you, accountant Zuki. That's so cool.
That Ritter account.
Not good, huh? The smell.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Animals. No matter how much I spray them down, they smell.
Some creatures are like that, yes.
Humans too.
I'd be interested in hearing your business plan here tonight.
I like his coat. No, not really. You can't click on things with an active inventory item, Paul. I see. Daniel didn't say that. He didn't tell me. He just lets me.
I told
squirm.
You in episode 3.
Yeah.
Check it out. I actually did.
You told me 10 minutes ago who we were talking to, and I forgot that. So I've got a short span of memory here.
This is like a memento, just with adventure games. You forget who you're playing, what game we're playing.
Cages and leave them there.
I know what to do with the hot dog. All right. I'll get there. That was an easy hint. Or maybe I'm just getting better. Maybe I'm just honing my instincts more.
What kind of exotics did you get for Grossberg?
Anything. Cats he mostly got. Things that make good coach, you know. Things you can't get on the market. But for you, you pay cash up front. I get you anything.
I just gave you 14,000.
Can you get hippopotamuses?
Okay. Maybe not anything. But most things I can get. You need some cats soon, huh? Gorilla. I can get gorilla.
Well,
how about werewolf?
It's possible. I'll let you know.
All right.
Well, the 14,000 you paid him was a debt.
Right, I know that. Still, it hurts. It wasn't Grossberg's money. It's from our Ritter account. That's not true. Did Grossberg harvest the furs or did you? So, okay.
Did Grossberg harvest the furs or did you?
Me? I do it. Only cost 250 marks extra, and I do a good job. You get the skin all clean for that. Not the meat. You pay more for the meat.
Naturally.
But every few months, Grossberg, he wanted the whole thing live. I don't know what he did with those. I don't ask questions.
I think I know.
Ooh, good. Good eyebrow raise. I can't do one eyebrow. Dang, okay. All right. I like the cello music.
Really? You can't?
Robert Holmes. No, I can't do the one. I can do one and then I... No, I can't do it. Can you?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. I don't think that's a normal thing. I think most of us can't do that. So good on you. Good on you, Daniel. Who else can do it?
Characters in movies.
Did you talk to Grossberg before he died?
Yeah, sure. A few days ago. I called the bastard for my money. He told me about you, you know.
He did?
Yeah, sure. Said he had a new business partner. And that soon he would have much money and could pay me everything. I thought he was lying. Now you show up. It's good for me he was telling the truth.
Shoulder pads?
Yeah.
No shoulder pads. How did the export go? He's an interesting character. Did you look this guy up?
You want to bring him on the conversations with Curtis?
No, I don't know.
Okay.
Maybe.
Usually I bring animals in, not sell them out. I worked hard to find someone to take those two.
It's a good music. I like the sounds of the animals.
The weird exotic animals.
Yeah.
Oh,
but every time he scratches himself, he's got,
anyway?
He's like Cyrus in Phantasm 1. He's scratching and itching.
But I don't believe it. The restaurant is what I think.
Do they sell wolf meat at Taiwanese restaurants?
Why not? They sell tiger. Those people, they eat anything.
There were two wolves, right?
Yeah, sure. Male and female.
Ooh, male and female. Not. Wow, these keep showing up. I thought we were done with our questions.
Could I see where you kept the wolf?
Yeah, sure. I kept them both in the last cage on the right. The one against the wall.
Yeah, I do. I like this lighting too, Boromir. I like the... I like the look of this particular scene that they created. It's... All right, so he said by the wall, what?
If I ever solve this case.
Exit.
Well, is it an exit or is it okay? Okay, good.
Wait. If I ever solve this case, I'll sick leave.
Okay. Greens and yellows. Greens and deans and yellows. I gotta reach out to him one more time and see if I can just gently nudge him to change his mind.
From now on, I'm gonna tag Dean every time we promote the
werewolf
live stream.
That's the guy from Frasier. Thank you, Clement. 1 pound of wolf meat. Bitter.
Bitter.
All right. Oh, what are we going to do? I'm going to click on it.
These animals are filthy. Hungry, too.
Yeah, they're hungry.
I'd like to put Dorn in one of these cages and leave him there.
Wonder what I can use. Maybe my wallet. No. Let's get... How do I... All right. Da-da-da-da. Come on. Come on. So this isn't a thing? Oh, maybe I have to get out of this scene first?
Or maybe you need to click it.
Click it.
Exit.
Well, I want to watch him. I want to watch him do some exit acting. Now I do it. See, I'm sure I am not the first person who felt like I wasn't able to get what I wanted here. I still might not be able to. Give it to me. I see it go white here. Huh. Okay, so
yeah, the highlighted icons are crap in this game. Well,
I'm clicking on everything.
Take a look at the cage again.
Okay.
Velvet Delusion says, I hope you can somehow get a hold of Dean. We got a hold of Dean, but he doesn't want to come on the show.
Yeah, he was very nice and said, I'm kind of done talking about this stuff for now.
For now. We're going to email him every day.
No. Let me just play the slow game. I'll get him. So now I do the hot dog?
Let's do a good cop, bad cop. You'll be the good cop. You email him every month.
He's going in all these cages.
I'll email leave him daily.
What's up? Godfet writes, hi guys, Carl Nemec, the phone guy, Mike from Phantas 1, has a YouTube channel, KJN Studio Original. Could be also a nice guest for a future interview.
The name of his YouTube channel is KJN Studio Original. It should have been Conversations with a Phone Guy.
They're right. So you said to look here, and I don't...
These animals.
If I try to get them...
There's another hotspot on the screen. Stop it with the sausage. Put it aside.
So when is there more than one hotspot in this game? This is an exit. Here.
These animals.
So that didn't do anything. So you can see why I don't...
These animals are filth.
I don't see anything, Daniel. So why would any... Who was going to...
Maybe...
That's an exit.
Maybe at the bottom of the cage, there is something you can pick up.
Oh, for God's sake, seriously? This is different than this. This is...
Yep.
Oh, my God.
This is called pixel hunting.
You guys didn't find this stuff. None of you found this
Our
stuff.
Our favorite pastime back in the 90s.
It took you months. Months and months. Jeez. Such a masochist. Oh, there we go. What's up, Tiger?
Hey, kitty, kitty. Some stock footage from National Geographic over there.
You're not even in a cage. Oh, now I can click. Now I can give you a hot dog.
That cat is just waiting for me to stick my arm in there again.
Or a tasty hot dog. Dang it. Still no. Oh, there we go. Yes. Now just let her take it gently from your hand. Just keep your hand there the whole time. And see how gentle she is. All this time just unwrapping a sausage. What?
You see, they were filming it on blue screen.
15
seconds.
And he's
looking both ways, even though there's a wall to his left.
Yeah, keep your hand there. Keep it there. Okay, good. And now take a time, look around. 3, 4, 5 seconds. All right, now are you going to eat it?
I think I'll leave the cat alone.
What? You just gave a hot dog. What? I want to see him eat. But what does that do? How does that help our cause? I just gave him a hot dog.
Maybe we should pixel hunt some more.
In this whole area?
In the cage.
In the cats, I was thinking I wasn't quite done yet. What is it? That noise is not... Okay, look at this. And he's getting a little sleepy. All right, so there's that thing again. All right, he's calmed down. He's not as hungry.
Some National Geographic. Badly rotoscoped.
Uh-huh. Looking for a pixel in a haystack. Monk, monk. Yes. Got it. See, you weren't hungry anymore, and I took you by surprise. Oh, I didn't even notice that before. Nice. He's like showing it off to the tiger. All right, we got what we wanted. Hot dog did your work. It's a web verse. It's a web verse. All right, I think.
If I have...
By the way, the only reason I told you to buy the sausage back when you were in Marienplatz was because you looked at the hot dog stand. Otherwise, I would have let you get here, which is the natural progress of the game.
Oh, and then,
you would have figured it out by yourself.
I think I would have. But also, I was obsessed with the hot dog lady anyway, so I probably would have gotten the hot dog had I known that. I had forgotten.
You can pay for it.
Yeah. So watch this. They're not going to let me back. So when I go this way, he walks out. But when I go this way, boom, he's right there. Inconsistency. Editing. All right, I guess we're done. Let's get out of here.
I'm not sure what else to say.
Me neither. Let's hit the road. Dang. No goodbye. Just a... Then there's a flash edit, and he's just outside. What is going on? All right, let's get out of here.
What did you pick up?
I picked up a thing. This thing.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at it.
What is that?
I don't know. We should take a look. Parsifal and Hilda. It's the dog tags of the werewolves. They're lovers. They're a couple. Now, if my theory that the Baron is the black wolf and... what's his name? Gabriel is the other wolf. Then that's two men. But if Baron is in love with Gabriel. Oh, I have to click on them. Thank you, Dan. All right.
Hilda and Possible's tags. So much for the killer zoo wolves theory. Hilda and Possible's tags. So much for the killer zoo wolves theory.
The theory is that they couldn't get close to him enough.
The theory that they didn't escape and killed.
All right. I hear whistling. Is that in the game? Or is someone whistling in your house?
Whistling in my house? It's midnight. What kind of household do you think I'm running here?
Your kids are up just doing a little whistling. All right, I need some. I love this part. Hints. Yeah, let's go back to Marienplatz. I like the hints. How's everybody doing? How are we doing? Yeah, people are sticking around. That's good. I have three places to go. I can go. Might as well check it out. I've got to go check them both out anyway. Oh, no. Let's go this way. That guy, always. I have a feeling I have nothing to tell that he has nothing for me. But let's see if... And I've got my red shirt.
Gabriel.
Oh.
Come in.
Hey, Harry.
He's happy to see me, which means maybe we have some stuff to talk about.
I don't have anything else to say right now.
Drats. Except I can show him the tags.
I'm not sure why I'd want to show him that.
Well, it's because I'm floundering here. I've already done this, right?
I'm not sure why I'd want to show him.
I got no reason to be here. I feel comfortable in saying I've gone to the wrong place. Unless I am told so otherwise.
I'm off. See you, Harry.
Okay. I need another hot dog.
Wait, did he call someone?
Did
when he left the office?
Oh, I think I skipped ahead. He might have. Let's see if I can get another hot dog while I'm here. I don't know why this makes me so... Oh, all right. But look at that. Whenever we click on her, we get to see her fidget her. She's getting more screen time in my playthrough than in any other Gabriel.
Let's get her on Conversations with Curtis.
She's my favorite.
So how was it playing the hot dog lady?
Yeah. You did one day
and
of
that's
fidgeting.
It. The live stream itself would be 3 minutes.
That's true, yeah. I would do that. All right, Hunt Club, what do we got for us here?
Not
his hair isn't black. He's not the black wolf.
There you are.
And everyone's dressed like it's World War II.
I don't really have any stuff. Von Agner said he had guns at the lodge.
Oh, we'll fix you up. Never fear. Gentlemen, let's go.
Let's go. Did you show me a clip from the actor who played Von Glauer? What's he doing now?
Well, he was on Baywatch Nights.
Yeah? Like a regular?
Yeah. Well, Baywatch Nights, I think, had one season. One season, right? It was canceled after one season.
Disco dance! Disco dance! Disco dance!
You two sleep in Price's room.
Thanks,
Gabriel,
Clement.
For now.
Herrgott sacre.
I'll read that in a second.
Yeah, Baron.
All right, there's some.
Your room is the last door on the left upstairs. Today, we relax. Tomorrow, we hunt.
We undress.
Today, we relax. I will be in your room somewhat after midnight. Great. Clement, thank you. Here is the SAG check for that lady's time on GK2. That's right. Her residual. Hey, this room looks a little bit like, I don't know, other rooms. All right, we got some more time. I am going to have to take care of some business, so I'm going to give you guys this is going to be called Dialogue with Daniel time.
No, it's Conversations with Daniel.
Well, I was doing Dialogue with Daniel because it's the, you know, it's alliterative thing. So Conversations, Curtis, Dialogue, Daniel. Anyways, everybody enjoy chatting with Daniel for the next 60
seconds. If you have questions about the Phantasmagoria 2 script, Phantasmagoria 2.1, the weather here, I'm game. Drunken rambling with Daniel, yeah, because you play the drinking game and you drink every time that Gabriel sighed, so that's a lot of times. Are you currently living in Israel? Yep. How's my midnight weather? Well, I have my AC running because it's 40 degrees Celsius, which is 100 degrees Fahrenheit. How are you enjoying guiding Paul? It's the most fun I ever had. So what is a Phantasmagoria 2.1 exactly elevator pitch? It's a Phantasmagoria 2 based fan game with some of the content from the original game and a lot of new content from the original cast and Paul. I'm late to the party. Ricardo asks, I'm late to the party, Daniel, but how did you meet Paul? Well, I'll talk about it on the live stream. On Tuesday, we'll do a live stream about Phantasmagoria 2.1. So we'll tell the story of how we met. I have a pair of black leather boots. No, but I'm selling these fine leather jackets. Whitey Wanderer says, leak the original Phantasmagoria 2 ending. Well, let me tell you something about the Kickstarter we had. We digitized the VHS tapes, and there are scenes there in which you can hear the director in Dimension X yelling out directions to Paul. How many languages do you speak? 3, which is English, Hebrew, and Romanian, because I was born in Romania.
Dang. Look at this. I love this dialogue with Daniel Time. This is great. We'll do a spin-off show. You'll have your own in no time. You'll do a clip speed. My job is to introduce Daniel to the world and then step aside. So, but until then, let's play some more GK2, shall we? All right. I have new stuff. I've got a room. I got a bed. I got an exit over here. I go back out. I think that's the door I just came in, but you never know with the perspectives in this game. So let's start with the closet. He's just going to tell me what it is. No, we got a scene. Ooh, does this have a secret passageway like the other one?
There's nothing in here.
Or is there? Is there a pixel search here? Do I need to look at something? I don't think I know that there's... I just gotta see the room. He says there's nothing in here. And then I'll check this.
I could use a shower, but I want to look around first.
Okay, let's keep looking around the
bed. I'll never be able to sleep in this place.
Let's go this way. We got ourselves a window. Uh-huh. Nighttime sounds. Ooh. Do we get to jump out of the window? Oh, down. I'm going to jump out the window?
I'd hate to get lost out there.
I mean, they probably figured out this there. Late in the game that they can write something other than exit on those arrows.
I've never seen that.
Which would make sense.
This is the first time, right? That it's changed.
Yep. Down. Look down.
Now we exit.
There's a ledge under the windows. Too bad it's not a little wider.
Uh-huh. This is good to know. A ledge under the windows. It's not wider.
There's a ledge.
Up. Up and down. And exit. He's going to have to hide out there at some point. And it's going to be dangerous because the ledge isn't wide. He might fall. All right, so we got a window with a ledge down below. Got new music. We got nothing in here. And that's it.
How could you?
All right, I'm leaving. Should I leave? Is it okay if I leave?
Yeah.
All right, good. Oh, I'm in a whole different spot. Look at this. My new best friend. Oh, he won't even talk to me. Oh, man. Dissed.
Great editing.
Excellent editing. All right, so we got a bunch of doors. 4 doors. Oh my gosh, we'll be here all night.
It's no use. Oh, let's start. I'll unlock it myself.
Let's start with the one next to Gabriel.
Okay. All right, a new one. All right. They all look the same, but I bet they're not. Clothes. A jacket. Oh, there's something right there. Ooh, things to take. Or things for him to tell us what they are. A whip. All right.
It's for Therese.
Ropes. That's right. You're going to keep the ropes? Oh, because you're going to hang go down and get the ledge. Can I check this stuff out? More stuff. I don't even know what I just took.
You just said that you take a robe.
Yeah, but it looks like he's taking something right now. Like, what's that stuff? Oh, so that's him just rummaging around, and then I click on this, and that's... I should have gone.
Yeah.
All right.
So you have the rope.
Got the rope.
What now?
I'm going to go to that ledge. But if you weren't here, I would have looked in that room a lot more, and then I would have checked all these doors out, which he's probably telling me that I can't. Oh, nope. Oh.
Come and see.
Oh, no. Well, I'm skipping ahead.
But look at you being all adventure gamey. What do you want,
but Mike? I would be.
Just scoping things out.
You're doing great, Paul.
Really? Look all you want at the great wonders of this room, then leave. I'm trying to rest.
The wonders of this room.
This is uncomfortable.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, I'm going to nap here, or I'll pretend to be napping, and you just sneak around. That's what we're going to do.
Take a shower. He's.
You just take a shower, and I'll be right here.
I can't snoop around too much. The clean one's here.
Yeah. You think so?
I can't snoop around too much. The clean one's here.
He wants me to snoop around a little bit. What kind of snooping can I do?
This is a very complex puzzle. First, you need to get a robe and a towel. And then you can come here and take a shower in front of him.
Ha ha. Are you kidding?
I may be serious.
Wait, so get out of here for now?
Yeah.
I wouldn't mind a chat, but Klingman...
Okay, so I can't... Oh my god. Well, now I want to check these other doors out.
It's no use. I saw him lock it myself.
All right. Did I do this one all right?
Okay, this is a different puzzle. Join him in the bathtub.
Sorry, didn't know you were busy.
Mach nicht. I'm always up for company.
Okay.
So, amuse me, Herr Knight.
Oh, Jesus.
Amuse you. Well, is this where he flash? If you click here and then here, he flashes him or something?
Yeah. This is a puzzle.
Gabriel Knight.
That's me, Gabriel.
Take out your sausage.
Oh my god, we're gonna have a conversation with a guy in a bathtub. This is...
By the way, I have a behind the scene photo of this scene. And he's actually in a bathtub. Not even pretending.
You have a picture of him in a bathtub.
No, I have a picture of this scene, behind the scenes picture of this scene, and they're standing in front of a blue screen, and there's an actual bathtub over there.
Wow. So they... Oh my gosh. All right, here we go.
Tell me about the club.
What about the amusement part? Wasn't he supposed to amuse him?
It's so tedious.
All right, we can talk about something else. Can I assume you're... fan of the club philosophy?
Well, look at me. I love to eat and I love to drink. I own a butchery and a brewery, which means I love people who love to eat and drink. If I could make it the national religion, I would.
Point taken.
And I love cleanliness. Grossberg.
Do you know what type of animal we'll be hunting tomorrow?
Deer, I suppose.
Oh, that's too bad. I mean, it's too bad we don't have something more interesting to hunt.
What do you mean?
Well, Grossberg's death's gonna make it difficult to get anything really challenging. Leopards, lions, things like that.
You enjoy what is sticking doing? Your neck out, don't you?
Do I?
If it were me, I wouldn't want to get on the wrong side of someone like Von Zell.
Mm-hmm. All right, were you at the club's main contact with Grossberg?
Were you the club's main contact with Grossberg?
Yeah. Buying and selling exotic animals isn't exactly legal in Germany. The others didn't want to know.
All right.
What does Baron Von Zell have to do with Grossberg?
Nothing.
But he knew Grossberg. You asked him about Grossberg the other night at the club.
My, what big ears you have.
Somebody said that earlier.
He gave Grossberg's name. Why?
Because he asked me for it.
You guys know this game backwards and forwards, don't you? Wow, more stuff. Questions.
Do you know why
Von Zell
wanted Grossberg's name?
He did not share his reasons with me.
Well, you must have thought something.
Yeah.
I assumed that since Von Zell was getting too big for his britches, and since he was no longer von Glauer's pet, that he had intentions of leaving and starting his own club.
And you didn't have a problem helping him go independent?
I would love to see him leave. And I'm not the only one.
What a great character.
I would like to see Gabriel leave this room. And I'm not the only one.
Cooperation have anything to do with money? Now, are you getting in this tub with me or not?
Even though Grossberg's name have anything to do with the money you owe Von Zell?
How do you know about the money? You only been with the club a few days. Did the Baron say something?
What's a big secret? Von Zell is a banker, isn't
he? That's right. He's a banker. And I am a successful businessman.
There you go.
In
and
a
he
bathtub.
Offered to cut your dad in half for a small favor. I understand. It's not your fault Grossberg's dead.
Okay, well, Oh, two more. All right.
Have you heard of the Black Wolf?
Nine, I don't know this.
Yes,
are you sure?
Maybe there are Black Wolves here, maybe not. I have never seen them, I have only heard them.
What do you mean you heard them?
These wolves in the woods. I'm glad I never saw them. They make such sounds. It makes your hair stand on end.
Now get in this bathtub.
You know, every other character that you asked about the Black Wolf would overreact, like Von Glauer when he dropped his glass. So here, I expected him to fall out of the bathtub or something.
Oh, it would have been great if he did like a big slip or something, yeah. If his stein of beer falls into his tub of water.
Are you telling me you've heard wolves around here?
Yeah, of course. You should be sure you don't go out in the dark at night. These wolves, sometimes they sound very close by.
But Klingman told me wolves are extinct in Germany, except for maybe a few in the Alps. We're not close to the Alps, are we?
Your air doctor is obviously mistaken. There are wolves in the woods. I've heard them myself many times.
All right. This is a good room to go into.
I think you should excuse yourself for a night. It's getting cold.
Oh, sure. No problem.
I could try you some more hot water.
Close the door on the way out, please.
Get a towel and give him the towel.
Wow. All right.
No, Phantasmagoria 1 and Phantasmagoria 2 have a censorship option. You can activate censorship so that they... raunchy scenes are censored. You should have done the same here with this scene. Yeah. Like, censored it completely.
I know. This is my room back here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I don't want to go back there yet because I know that's where I want to take the rope and go out of the ledge, I think. But I think I have two more. I can't get in there. I think I've already gone in there. This is my... Oh, I got another one. Oh, there's our boyfriend.
All settled there?
Uh-huh. Nice place.
Yes, it is. You should go for a walk. The woods are beautiful, and you could get your bearings before tomorrow's hunt.
Good idea.
It's nice and dark out there. Nothing will...
Okay. Now get the whip.
He's busy. Friedrich wouldn't appreciate me messing around in here.
Get the whip. All right.
No, there's no whip.
Oh, that's the rope. Okay. Oh, you're just being goofy. I get it. You're being all ha ha. All right. See, I take you literally at everything at this point. So. Nothing else to do here.
Friedrich wouldn't appreciate me messing around in here.
All right, you're telling me to go. All right, let's get out of here.
Friedrich wouldn't appreciate me messing around
in
here.
See, I clicked on the door, and so now if I gave up, I'd say there's no way for me to get out. But
Friedrich wouldn't appreciate me messing around in here.
How do I get out of here? What? What the hell? Is there an exit anywhere? That looks like the door.
Friedrich wouldn't appreciate me met.
Oh, for.
He's busy.
I can't get out of here. There's no. Oh, what's that? Exit. There is the exit? That's where they put the exit.
Hmm?
That's
Gabriel's head.
Do I want to go? He told me to take a walk, right? So I think I'm going to take a walk, not go back into my room. I'm going to follow the clues, like Daniel said earlier. All right, I can talk to this dude, of course. Except I don't. I go there somewhere else.
I wish someone would start a fire.
Okay. I'm going to ask that. All right. Let's talk to this guy.
Hey, Henneman. Looks like we finally have a chance to talk.
Well, as long as my glass is full, you can ask me anything you like.
And I'm all done. Goodbye.
Anything you like.
All right. Do I have this much beer's worth of questions? All right.
Oh. Hiya.
That was perfect. Look at that. Curtis just sort of takes over Henneman's head right there. That's perfect timing. Thanks, Clement. Let's help Von Agner to heat up his bath. Thanks, man. All right. I think we're going to get through this guy, and then we're going to have to call it a Friday and let everybody get on with the rest of their weekend here, the beginning of their weekend. All right, here we go. Oh, I clicked on the OBS screen and not the game.
Are you especially close to anyone at the club?
Oh, I drift on the fringes, Herr Knight. You, however, seem to have gone straight to the top.
Oh, I don't think so.
Don't be modest. Everyone can see you as a new golden boy. Why do you think Von Zell bothers to hate you?
Are you and Von Zell good friends?
No, I was never good enough for Von Zell. Now, I get along better with those who do not think so much of themselves.
Von Agner?
Yeah, Von Agner's a good man. Dr. Klingman, too, I like. He comes by the Donizel and drinks with me sometimes. Well, you could stop by sometime if you want. Yeah, I don't like drinking alone.
Thanks.
He hasn't offered him a drink,
maybe
though.
I will.
Yeah.
He's drinking alone.
He offered his friendship.
He's drinking alone.
You and Klingman make an unlikely pair. What do you find to talk about?
A doctor likes to discuss the club philosophy. He's very enthusiastic, you know. That's what made him want to join in the first place.
You sponsored Klingman's membership?
Me? No, Von Zell.
Von Zell? He doesn't seem like the welcoming type.
Oh, that's what I thought, too. You know, when Von Zell brought Klingman in, I thought they must be very close. But the way Klingman asks questions, you'd think he hardly knew Von Zell. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. I mean, who can say why Von Zell does anything?
Is there any reason you don't want a room with Price?
No, you may not have noticed, but the man is a rotting schwein.
Man,
why the Baron puts up with him, I will never
dialect.
Know. I can tell you what he's doing right now, up there in his room. He has shut himself in the bathroom, and he isn't taking a bath.
Yes, he is. He was just,
tell you,
we were just there.
You can't turn your back on a man like that. No one is safe.
Oh, that's not on sale. The other guy was taking a bath. Oh, look at his fidgeter. It's kind of a pleasant little smile. That's it.
It's nice and pathetic.
I thought Price was a hotshot lawyer.
Yeah, was 10 years ago. He's lucky he doesn't need the money now because he can't get work.
Why not?
He's too obvious with his nature, you know? Okay, so maybe other men are like this, you know, thinking only what's between their legs. Price, he has no respect for normal human decency. He flaunts his perversion.
Everyone flaunts their perversion over here.
Instincts, being primal?
Yeah, okay, so it is. That's a question for the Baron, not for me. I only say what I see about Price.
I see nothing.
This is a nice hunting lodge. Do y'all come here often?
Oh, at least once a month altogether. Oh, we can come anytime we want by ourselves.
Do you have any other properties where y'all hunt?
Yeah, we have a lodge at Alfdorf, but we don't go there much. Ooh, it's not so convenient.
New location, Alfdorf.
Alfdorf.
Mm-hmm. That's going to come up. Better. More lodge. Some black
is
wolf.
Is the club in Alfdorf close to a forest, too?
Not close. In. It's in the Naturpark Schwäbisch-Frankische Wald.
Of course it is.
And black wolf it.
Have you ever heard of the black wolf?
Spittake.
Black wolf?
Ah.
No.
That would have been perfect. That's it?
A spit take would have been understandable. What von Glauer did was a spit take with his hands.
Yeah. Oh, I thought that was a very short conversation about the black wolf. All right, I'm going to save this. We're going to call this... Where are we? Where are we, anyway?
The hunting lodge.
Lodge, yeah. All right. All right. So saved. And how did we do today, Daniel? Are we still five, six
episodes away from chapter six?
How close are we to chapter six?
Well, it all depends what happens next week and okay. How long that live stream will be.
Yeah.
And if you'll remember how to play the game.
I won't. But I'm enjoying rediscovering it every single time as though it's the first. I live every day fresh. In my gaming world. Daniel, thank you so much, as always, for joining. And everybody, please remember that next Tuesday, and we'll have a promo coming out this next few days, Daniel and I will be unveiling his updated, brand new version of what we currently are calling Phantasmagoria 2.1. Anything you want to tell us before... you guys have to join us. It's a live stream.
Yeah.
We're going to play this game. It's so cool. You have to check it out. Lots of new stuff. Anything?
No. You'll have to join us on Tuesday to find out what we have in store for you.
All right.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you, everyone. And don't forget the announcement.
I won't. Thank you for mentioning that. And everybody say bye to Daniel. Appreciate that. And we will see you next time. All right. Well, let me turn. I guess I can get rid of the game now. All right, so that is the end of our gameplay. Thank you for joining. Really appreciate it. And thank you so much for the super chats. You guys, that's the most we've ever made in one game session before. And thank you to Zuki for the... she just wrote, you ended on $120.66 super chat tips. Thank you very much for your bookkeeping and for your contributions. If I gave you your share, then that would have... meant that you didn't help make it happen. So thank you so much. But my announcement, for anybody who is currently a Patreon member or anybody who would like to be a Patreon member, all of our interviews from now on, the interviews that I do, are going to be Patreon exclusive. So as soon as I'm done here, I'm going to hit post on my interview with Steve Bailey, the actor who played Cyrus in Phantasmagoria 1. We had an incredible conversation and he could not have been more fun. We have a long history together and we got to talk about that. So in the next few minutes, my full interview with Steve Bailey will be available for all of my Patreon members. Now, for those of you who can't join Patreon for whatever reason, totally get that. And what we'll do is with all of our interviews in the future.
Piss off conversations with Curtis.
Thanks for following, Jelly Duck. We will make sure that all the videos are available on YouTube. Oh man, you guys are being so sweet. I'm trying to, who is that? James Jenkins. Thank you, James. Appreciate it, man. And we reached 1,000 messages today between YouTube and Twitch. That's pretty awesome. So anyway, Steve Bailey will be available on Patreon. We're going to make the first part of that interview available to anybody for free on our YouTube channel. And then we will release that video in segments over the next month or so. So people can watch the whole thing eventually, but for anybody who wants to watch it now, and I highly recommend doing so, please check it out on Patreon in a matter of minutes. All right. Have a good one, everyone. Happy Friday, happy weekend, and we will see you next Tuesday to unveil the new name and the new game from Daniel Albu, all to do with Phantasmagoria 2 and Conversations with Curtis. All right. Take care, everyone. Have a great weekend. Bye. Thanks to Patreon members. Have a good one, all.